Hey guys, it's Bea. Welcome back to my channel. So today's video is another tour purchase or not skincare product review. So the product that we're going to talk about today is Haemish's Marine Care Eye Cream. So this is the product right here. And as always, verdicts first. In terms of like repurchasing this product, I'd say it's a no. Not because it's not a good product, but yeah, I'm still looking for sort of like the perfect eye cream for me. But nevertheless, like in summary, like my experience with the product is overall good. It's just that some under eye concerns aren't really like solved by this product, but nevertheless, it's a really good product. So the reason why I decided to buy this product is actually I was just like hyped up into it. I was like looking at Haemish's like new products and I saw this one. I got interested because I'm always on the search for like a good eye cream, and in one of the descriptions they were like comparing it to the La Mer eye cream, which is like a premium luxury brand. So even though like I don't use that product, it's too much out of my price range, you just like get hooked into it. So yeah, I got hyped up into like buying the product. But yeah, like the overall description of the product seemed like something that I was looking for as well. So yeah, let's like talk about the ingredients or like the description of the product. So this is a description from their website. So Haemish presents you the Marine Care Eye Cream made to flatten your wrinkles, hydrate your skin, and brighten your complexion. This rich and thick cream is recommended to use at night to help your skin absorb all of the nutrients and minerals so that you can kick off the morning with a bright start. So this is made with fermented seaweed extract and mineral-rich seawater. It rejuvenates the area around the eye, lessen the appearance of wrinkles and fine lines, including peptide collagen adenosine, reduces puffiness, and comes with a cooling eye roller ball to help massage the cream under your eyes. Protects skin's natural barrier and provides moisture with enriched peptide and plant stem cell extract. Brightens and moisturizes dark complexion with 51% of miracle marine water and 2% niacinamide. So in terms of like under eye concerns, like my main concern is dark circles. So like based on the description, it seems like it's a perfect product for me. And also like, of course, like helping with fine lines and wrinkles is a good plus. So like overall, the description is alluring. It seems like a good fit for me. In terms of like my experience with the product, I didn't really experience like a significant difference in terms of like the shade of my under eyes. It didn't really brighten that much. What I experienced was more on the lines of color correcting effect. I don't know if it's because of like the tint of the product, which has like a greenish tint to it. So like when I apply it under my eyes, it sort of like color corrects that redness that sort of like darkens the under eye area or something like that. So that's like what I got from it. And in terms of like using it during the day versus during the night, I actually like tried both. At first I was trying it during the night, but you know, like during the next day I didn't really experience like a big or significant effect in terms of like using the product. And I feel like it's not because of like the length of how much I use the product, because I've actually been testing it out since December, I think. So that's like around 2 months tops. So I've been using the product for a relatively long period before like making this review. In terms of like using it during the daytime, I actually preferred using it during the daytime because yeah, like I said, it sort of had that color correcting effect that sort of like alleviates the dark circles a little bit. It's not a totally like lightened under eye situation, but it does help it. It has a very natural look to it, but it's not as good as a concealer, you know? So in terms of like the anti-wrinkle fine line sort of effect, I didn't really see a significant change or improvements for my under eye. So yeah, that's like another thing about it. However, like in terms of like moisturizing my under eyes, I feel like it did really a good job at that. Like the description said, it has this like thick consistency. So yeah, it is thick and rich. However, it isn't really uncomfortable under the eyes. I actually prefer using it during the daytime. It has a really good finish and it doesn't really look like you applied an eye cream or something like that, because the other eye creams I've tried, you know, there's like a glistening like finish to it. So yeah, this one, it looks really natural under the eyes and it's a good for like a no makeup kind of look, a simple like daily look, something like that. So I actually tried using it before wearing a concealer. In terms of like how it was, I didn't really like the finish overall. It felt like the concealer sort of like concentrated on specific parts of my under eye where the eye cream was applied. So yeah, I wouldn't suggest like using a concealer with it or like using it before wearing makeup, but that's just like my experience. You could also like try for yourselves, but yeah, for me, it's not a good combination. So I actually wanted to talk about the packaging as well. So the box that came along with it is actually pretty nice. I haven't thrown it out yet because I find it a very useful way to store the product. As like the description mentioned, it came with this like roller ball thing, which is supposed to help with like massaging the eye cream under your eyes for like absorption and things like that. I tried it out. It's okay. It's not really my thing, but if that's like something you frequently do, you might appreciate that this eye cream does come with this like roller ball massaging thing. The other end of this like rollerball massage thing has this like, sort of like a scooper kind of situation going on. So I have been actually using this as a scooper for my eye cream. So I actually prefer using the scooper to like get some of the product versus dipping my fingers on the tub. So yeah, overall the packaging for me was really good. So yeah, I just like store it all in the box. It's a lot more like tidy that way as well. Just an FYI as well, this product has fragrance in it. It actually smells nice. I love the scent of the product. However, some people are really particular with fragrances in their skincare. So if that's you, you might not like this product. So like just a warning about the product. It has like a fragrance to it. It's quite strong actually, but it smells nice. So I really like enjoy the scent of the product. Overall, I didn't really have any like negative or bad experiences with like using the product. Nothing negative, like didn't really cause any breakouts or something like that. So yeah, that's always like good to know about a product. I think this is one of the eye creams that is definitely worth a try. So if ever like the description fits your needs and you're willing to give this eye cream like a try, definitely go for it. So yeah, that's it for my review for the Haymitch Marine Care eye cream. If you have any comments or questions about this product, feel free to put them down on the comment section below. If you like this video, feel free to click the like button. And if you want to be updated for my future uploads, feel free to subscribe to my channel. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. This is actually one of the better eye creams I've tried. I was like trying to list down all of the eye creams I've tried in my life and it was surprisingly a lot. I didn't expect that I've tried a lot of eye creams already. I feel like I haven't really tried a lot, but surprisingly I have. So in case you're interested, I'm gonna like list them down for you. So like the first one I ever tried was the Innisfree one, which I didn't really like. I hated that product. I wouldn't recommend it because I got milia from like using it regularly. And then the next one I got to try was like the Mijon snail repair eye cream. That really didn't really do anything for my under eyes, so not really a recommended product. Another one that I got to try was the Benson fermentation eye cream. That was like okay. I didn't see anything significant from like my experience using it, but then again, I used like a sample size and like the consistency was kind of like dry And I'm not sure if like the actual product has that kind of dry consistency, but yeah. The next one that I got to try was the Ulf Henriksen banana, right? Something something eye cream. Again, didn't really get anything from trying out the product. I think I tried it out for a week. And then the next one that I got to try was the fresh black tea eye cream. That one was good. I got results from that, but that one is really expensive. And it's like four times the price of the Neogen eye cream and also the Hamish Marine Care eye cream. So yeah, it's out of my price range, definitely, but it's a good product. And then like the more recent ones I got to try was the Neogen Perfection 100 eye cream. That one was good. And then this one, the Hamish Marine Care eye cream, this is good as well.